Hi everyone, just a quick mention of my book before today's video starts. Watercolour Painting Made Simple by myself, Stephen Cronin. Available on Amazon, hardback, softback, Kindle. So that's on Amazon. Details in the description below. So let me show you today's video. Hi folks, I'm Stephen Cronin. Thanks for joining me again today. This is Cuckoos Nook, which is not far from where I live. I'm painting from a photograph. I was up there the weekend. So before I show you how I painted this, let me show you the photograph. So the main challenge here is going to be sort of filtering out all this excess detail. There's twigs, trunks, branches, leaves all over the place. Some nice reflections down there in the water. So before I get started, let's show you the colours I've used. On the palette, we've always got them in the same order. We've got ultramarine, lemon yellow, Payne's grey, alizarin crimson, raw sienna, burnt umber, and light red. And use the larger on Ranson Ake. And mainly the number 3 Riga. So they're the only two brushes, predominantly. And they're all Cotman watercolours. So I'm just starting with a little bit of clean water, and then I want to, I don't think I'll bother with a pretty much blue sky. I'm just going to put a sort of abstract, plenty of green, background, loads of reflection of that in the water. Grey to darken in areas. Just trying to create sort of atmospheric backdrop to this scene. Right. Dicks, I'm just going to do a sort of so just sort of en masse, things just leaving there. Roll up the top. That's a little bit too strong, I think. Just try and tone it down slightly. Get some tree trunks in there now, so a bit of brown, same colours, I'll just add a little bit of brown to it all. And I'm gonna start flicking up all sorts of things. Don't forget the reflections down below. Stronger. Put some of that far banky. So it's differentiate. I'm just going to add what am I going to add? Start with the lemon yellow. I'm just going to go with a bit of ultramarine. Bit of light red in there as well. I'm just going to alternate, bring that down, clean the brush. I've gone a little bit too dark. Come down from that side. Need to come down somewhere down there like that. slightly rises just a little bit. Get this flat against this easel, and I'm going to go back to the rigger brush and put some more branches in, some more tree trunks and things. So lots of paint, lots of water. Also some stronger ones. Some of these are going right at the top. Put the reflections in as you're doing them. Slightly behind it. Little thin ones up there, and the reflections as well. I'll put a bit of foliage on them in a sec. In fact, let's do it now. Let's do it now. Just clean the brush, squeeze the water out. And then just dry brush on a bit of ultramarine, a bit of lemon yellow. Paint ground there as well, just a touch of light red, it loves to change it slightly. Right, and then over there, keep stronger. It's growing. It's all going a little bit too muddy there. Back into the lemon yellow. Just topping that on top of some of this. So the rigger brush, a bit of brown, a bit of blue, a bit of yellow. Now these, hang on, it's just, first of all, I'm just checking. Got some really strong ones now. Now this is a really strong branch and it's coming out and it's stronger than all of these. So I'm going to paint this one in really thick. Little branch coming out there like that. Put that reflection in. Behind it. I should put this one in first, really. Don't forget that reflection. Put this one in as well. little bit of dry brush work, so I'm just squeezing the water out, cleaning the brush. Just want a bit of lemon yellow. Hopefully this has got a bit sticky, so I might get, be able to get some nice dollops of it. Just little bits, a bit messy in there. Can't resist scraping the odd little rock in. Too mad, a few reflections down as well. Right, let's move on to this land on the left. It's going in. It's a little bit weaker than that, I think. Start off with a bit of brown up there. A bit of red. Blue. Just want to vary it to keep it interesting, just jutting out a little bit. And on this left hand side, we've got a hole. Load of things growing from this left hand near side bank. Starting with this one here. Just keep reloading the brush. Things down the banks. Right, let's put these big ones in there, brown, blue. The big one there, so I'm pressing right down on the paper. It's going up there like that. Big one up there. Put that base a little bit stronger. Branches coming off it. Another one just to the left. Is it this great big thing that just cuts straight across like that? I'm not going to go right across as far as it does in the actual reference photo because I think it helps the composition if I bring it all the way. I'm just going to hold it there, I think. Just a few little things coming off it. There. let's put a bit of foliage on this stuff that I've just put in. So I'm just cleaning the brush, squeezing the water out with thumb and forefinger, and then just drying it on the tea towel. It's going to a bit of lemon yellow, a bit of ultramarine. I just want to do something with this water. I just want to make sure it's dry first. Just make sure the paper's flat before I do that. Quick blast. I just want a very clean, damp paintbrush. Let's bring that to an edge. Those hairs out. Let's bring that to an edge like that. And I'm just going to using a clean damp brush just to create some sort of ripples and things on the water. Making sure that I keep the brush parallel with the bottom of the paper. I don't want them leaning one way or another. That's that's enough of that, I think. Right then, a few little shadows. So let's just mix a very simple shadow colour. A bit of brown, a bit of red, a bit of blue. Mix that together on the palette. This is predominantly shadow. And there. Can we just let's do that a little bit better. Just pick up some shadows on those spar trees. I'll just mix that again. Same colours. Shadows just going up the hill there. little shadowy bits here and there. I'll just squeeze a bit of neat yellow eyes. I just want a clean, damp, dry brush. I'll just scuff that up. So it's just going to put that. See the little rock here and there. The light's just catching it, like. Something like that. Let's just take a little bit of neat yellow. And I'm just gonna just dot it around. There is a near side, I haven't put that in, have I? I'm not going to worry about that anymore. There's sort of near, very immediate foreground branch coming down here, but I'm not going to, I don't think I'm going to worry about that. Put some of that in the water. I think what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pop in our little bird. Let's get it darker. I'm going to call that one done already. So let's pop my name in the corner and then I'll stick a name so I can see what he looks like.
Keep your name down there.
Right. Let's see what it looks like in the mount. There's our finished painting in the mount. So let's have let me show you the photograph. So I've kept the composition very, very similar. And it's basically a case of filtering out all this excess detail. There's twigs and branches all over the place. So the first thing I did, we've got these trees here on the top of this sort of ridge line here on the far bank. So I'll put those in first. Just put in very, very simply, just blocks them in en masse. But initially I put them in too dark, so I'll just lighten them a little bit. Then you can see the far bank. So it sort of comes down here like that to the water's edge. So I've tried to vary that as much as possible. Added a little bit of a light red and burnt umber and ultramarine here and there. Scraped out a few little rocks just to try and keep it interesting. And then you can see all these trees growing up this bank. So I've done them in various stages as the paper's dried. So the furthest ones are putting while the paper's still wet. So they soften off and get pushed back into the distance. And then the closest ones go on when the paper's dry in the strongest tones, and it helps create this sort of three-dimensional effect. Don't forget to do the reflections at the same time. Makes the water look more realistic. You can see where I've just poured a dry hake through it, just try and create these ripples. Make the water just look a little bit more like water. Can't see much of the left-hand bank, quite narrow, and again just a whole mass of twigs and foliage, so I had to filter a lot of this excess detail. So again, I brushed it in dark, bit of light red, ultramarine, tried to vary it slightly, a little bit of rocks and stones. You can see a bit of neat lemon yellow there as well, just to break up that darks. And then plenty of rigger work and a bit of dry brush work with the foliage again, a few leaves, but on with a dry hake. So in all, nice little scene. And once you learn how to filter out the all that excess detail, it becomes a lot more enjoyable process. So that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy that. Remember, books on Amazon if you want to check that out. All the materials and things are listed in the description. The paintings on eBay. So until next time, keep practicing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.